A middle school student shot multiple times in his own bedroom. Tonight, WLKY speaks with the teen's mother as police search for a killer. WLKY Steve Tellier joins us now in the newsroom with the disturbing details. Steve?
Rick, a mother returns from the grocery store to find her home broken into and her 15-year-old son shot to death. No suspects, no arrests, and no solace for the victim's family.
I wouldn't trade him for the world, but right now I would trade my life for his life back.
Gregory Holt was 15 years old and, according to his mother, healthy, happy, and hopeful. But his hopes were shattered around 1:30 Wednesday morning.
I just don't understand how I can go to the grocery store and come back and find my son, you know, in his room, dead.
Kendra Wilson had just been grocery shopping when she returned to her home on the 1600 block of Clover Street. Signs of something sinister were everywhere.
I walked up to my door and I seen it had been kicked in. I run straight to his room. His door is locked and there's 4 bullet holes in his door. I run to the kitchen, I get a knife. I open the door.
She then made the most terrible discovery a mother can make.
The policeman heard me screaming so loud, he came out and ran up my steps in my house in his room. He came back out and I said, is my son dead? And he said, yeah, and I just passed out.
She says Gregory was lying on the floor near his bed as if he had tried to hide under it. He was dead from multiple gunshot wounds.
I don't know nothing. I'm lost. I don't understand how a person could do something like that to a child.
Wilson doesn't believe the motive was burglary, as she didn't notice anything missing from her home. But she also doesn't believe her son was targeted.
He hasn't had any fights, any altercations, or anything. He's been the perfect child.
And he will always remain perfect in his mother's memory.
I'm going to miss him so much. I just don't know what I'm going to do with my life now.
Police are saying very little about this case. They have not elaborated on a possible motive and have not named any suspects. If you have any information you can share with them, you're asked to call them at 574-LMPD. I'm Steve Tellier, WLKY News.